Yo, that's so dope.
I love how Taylor is taking directing into her own hands. That's pretty cool.
Yes.
What's up? Jordan Orme here. I'm a professional music video editor, and I've been lucky enough to work with artists that are freaking amazing. Artists like Justin Bieber, Post Malone, Roddy Ricch, Tyga, G-Eazy, Quavo, Kehlani, Sway Lee, Megan Thee Stallion, and many, many more. I was sick, but now I'm out of my bedroom, out of quarantine, and I appreciate you all for all the get well soon wishes. That was very kind. We're here back with another episode.
Can I join you? Can I join you?
Yeah, you can join me. Good morning, everyone. We're going to talk about Taylor Swift.
I do that.
We're going to do another one for you Swifties. We're going to do...
I can't open my juice. Can you open my juice for me?
Your hair is in it. Get it off. I can't open it either.
Yay.
Thank you. Oh my gosh, you're five. I brought Ashley here today because, well, she kind of forced herself in. Here.
I brought you.
Here. Oh!
Okay. Also, hi. My name is Ashley. I'm dating this professional video editor. He does cute things. I've been a fan of Taylor Swift since her first album. I think I've watched every single one of her music videos at least 10 times.
So this one was directed by Taylor Swift. Herself.
A queen.
Actually, fun fact, I'm like internet friends with the editor, and his name's Chancellor Haynes. He's super awesome. I saw that he edited this, and I was like texting him last night. I was like, bro, good job editing this. How did you do it? Cardigan by Taylor Swift, which we're gonna get into right the frick now.
Yeah. Now. Why do you look so disappointed in me all the time? Like, everyone's like, oh, the way he looks at me and the way you look at me is with
disappointment. I promise it's not. Vintage tea, brand new. Vivo, I'm trying to watch Taylor Swift. I know it's been like one shot, one and a half shots. Editors, when you start a scene, we start on a clear frame. So we start on anything that's not a person. You could like start on a hand holding a glass, or sometimes you start on the sky and then the camera tilts down. Usually you like to start on an insert. So it's like we have the piano and it's like, oh, I don't know where we are, but there's a piano and it creates a mystery. If we just cut in on this shot, we could do that, but that kind of violates a rule of filmmaking. Usually when you start a scene, you always have a clear frame. So remember that. Vintage tea, brand new phone, high heels on, cobblestones. When you are young, they assume you know nothing.
First things first, this man in the thing is your grandpa. Second things second, Swifties. We have a 13. If you know anything about Taylor Swift, 13 is like her number. So the clock is pointing towards 1:15, but that means the hands are at 1 and 3. So she always just goes back to that.
I love it.
We love it.
We love it. What's the painting about?
It's about a house, as you can see, because there's a house.
Great theory tip. Thank love you. That.
Thank you. Politics.
She's such a good actress. Like, that's why her video seems so cinematic.
It's magic. Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe.
Really is.
Shout out to C.S.
Wow. Wow. Look at this environment. It's so beautiful. This is more of a VFX thing, but look, she's freaking chopped in half. Your girlfriend, she's upset. She's going. What you do here is you shoot a plate, which means you shoot basically the background of the shot with nothing going on in it. So we shoot basically this entire scene, but without Taylor Swift. So we get this footage right here, and then we have Taylor Swift come out of whatever contraption she has. That is the bench. And then we put in this little tiny bit of footage of the blank plate to cover up the bottom of the bench. And then it looks like she's coming out of freaking nowhere. And it looks super cool. But it's a really easy VFX shot that honestly anybody could do in your own work.
Create plate comp in. Sorry, I was taking notes.
You're cute. All the other VFX, though, that we see is not easy at all. It's freaking hard as frick. It's a really cool concept, though. Great job, Taylor, with this idea. Oh, my mom's texting me. I love you, Mom. Mwah. I love my mom.
Your mom is great. I was your favorite. What if she got married during quarantine? That's why she's wearing a white dress. Is a friend to none. Chase two girls,
lose the one. When you are young, they assume. Yo, that's so dope. What does this remind you of?
You guys remember Rary Riles?
Rary's back. Guys, this looks like freaking.
It looks like falling.
Guys, look at this.
You missed me too. There's so much between these two videos too.
This literally looks like the same video.
He's wearing white.
There's freaking water coming out the piano. Look at this. It's literally the same thing we just watched.
And she dropped it on the 10-year anniversary of One Direction.
Oof, I see you, waterfall piano. Chancellor, I see you. You show the wide shot, the grand wide shot that we have right at the beginning of the chorus. So right when the chorus starts, we show this beautiful wide shot with the waterfall piano, and it just looks gorgeous. So editors, remember, show wide shots at the beginning of choruses as a way to introduce a grand reveal of a scene. So I see you, Chancellor. I appreciate you, dude. The edit is just has such a nice flow to it. So dreamy. It really does. It's nice and slow. We love this pace.
We're seeing her sing in a register that we really have never heard her sing in. Like, she's singing so low, and Taylor Swift's thing is usually, like, she doesn't usually go above, like, a D when she's singing. Mm. But right here we have her, Cardigan. Like, it's really, really low. Mm. It's almost, like, in a reverse way, like, giving dreamy vibes.
And pat! Double dream hands.
Like it's like a sleepy memory kind of a thing. It's comfortable, which I think fits the song. An old cardigan that you have under your bed is comfortable. And there's like comfort in the memories of lost love, I feel like is kind of what this is saying. There's a lot of ties to the guy that she's been dating for 3 years, like through the lyrics of this song.
I also love how the video just supports that dreamy quality that you're talking about in the audio, how it's all low and just like the editing of the video also feels like that because it's very slow, pace is really gentle, like everything just feels warm and fuzzy. Oh my gosh.
This is more falling in like imagery.
It's not a gentle video anymore. It kind of is. Still. Oh my gosh. Drowning. Oh my gosh. Can you tell me why Taylor's music has such a great like storytelling feel to it?
I think it's because she started in country.
Country boy, I love you.
And country music, is so traditionally
like story
based.
And so because she has her roots in country, she has the ability to storytell and is bringing that over into pop music, which is kind of changing the pop music game.
We see more stories in pop music now.
Taylor Swift freaking is invented.
We love Taylor Swift.
Yes. It's like music is keeping her afloat.
Yeah. It's like what she clings to.
When she can't see anything else around her.
Exactly. When she's in the storm, she's clinging to music. This is a long shot.
pull all the way out and then go all the way back in. It's beautiful.
Music is always there.
Exactly, that's the theme of the story.
Under her feet. Literally, music is always there under her feet. When she steps out of the piano, she has keys under her feet. It's holding her up when she can't see anything else. It's a thing that takes her to different places. It's a thing that makes her feel different things. She feels anxious when she's in the water. She feels comfortable when she's in here. She feels, I don't know what emotion that is, but she feels that. In the forest, like wonder and awe.
Yeah,
when she's in the forest, and music's the thing that takes her to those certain places.
Wow, that's beautiful.
The fact that she just put something that fuzzy on over her wet body makes me want to throw up.
I know. I didn't feel good about that. I love how Taylor is taking directing into her own hands. That's pretty cool. She's no Joseph Kahn. I'm going to say it. She's no yet.
Yet.
But she's practicing and she's getting better. This was a very simple video, but she did a really good job with it. That was well done, Taylor. She's a very talented woman, that Taylor Swift.
And she knows her Easter eggs, too. Like, I bet there's a whole bunch that we didn't even catch.
I know. There's probably so many. And we're here in the AM just like...
Good night! In one's bed, you put me on and said I was your favorite.
Shop the cardigan.
By the way, if you want to look like this, buy the cardigan.
Buy the cardigan, everyone.
This was such a good ad.
I love this cardigan commercial.
For just $4 a month, you can support this young artist on his journey to fulfill his dreams. With your support on Patreon, you can become an executive producer. You can help pick the next video. You can help him follow his dreams. Your help is greatly appreciated. Thank you. Stop fake crying over everything I do.
If you like this video and you like to see other videos like this, we react to more Taylor Swift videos together, and it's freaking awesome, so go check those out. Now it's time for the moment we've all been waiting for,
You put me on and said I was your favorite.
This is like Jordan actually like reacting to like Taylor Swift and stuff, and we'll like see you later, so bye.